Now, it may have taken 39 years, but Wham finally have their Christmas number one with Last Christmas. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the
very next day, you gave it away. So it's been up against the likes of Sam Ryder, Mariah Carey for the top spot. Well, George Michael wrote the track in his bedroom in 1984. But it missed out on the top spot, so Band-Aids Do They Know It's Christmas. So his bandmate, Andrew Ridgeley, said he knew the song was a hit from the moment he heard it.
There was a footy match on the telly and he jumped up, disappeared upstairs where he had a little four-track studio, came back about an hour later and said, Andy, you've got to listen to this. Absolutely. I rarely saw him as excited or as animated as that. And he had the bare bones of Last Christmas, and it was a jaw-dropping moment. You know, as soon as he heard it, as soon as I heard it, it was so apparent that it was had all the hallmarks of a Christmas classic.
I love that song. And you know what? It's a bit late in the whole Christmas season, in the run-up to Christmas, but if you're before you write in or message about Whamageddon, couldn't help it. You know, no. Whamageddon is like you can't listen to a Wham song
before, in the run-up Christmas. To,
before Christmas. And what's the date today?
We're near enough now. It's the
23rd. It's...
All bets are off.
It's going to happen every hour as well, so...
Just in case. You tell
Sarah,
it.
There's your warning. When were you Whamageddoned? Oh, I can't hear you, Sarah. Hold on. We'll get you... Let's get your sound up. Have we got you? Try again.
Have you got me?
Yes,
yeah,
I got
you.
Oh, got you. Did you play Whamageddon, I suppose? Because I never play it, but were you Whamageddoned?
I was slightly Whamageddoned quite early this year, November, I think.
Oh, wow, that is early.